Hi, I'm Brian from Transylvania, and I'm going to do another Bible reading in a second. When I was a child, through my early adult years at a, I feel, kind of strange Bible college, I was told repeatedly, you should go to church like you're dressing up to meet God. And this could mean anywhere from this could be anywhere for guys wearing a suit to occasionally dressing business casual with a polo shirt and khaki jeans, khaki pants. And girls would often wear dresses and skirts that were down to the knee. Some would wear slacks, but yeah, there was like a definite God dress code that was, explicitly implied, and if you did not fit that mold, you were not going to be looked upon as a proper Christian. Now, most people have it together in their head enough that that they know God sees what's on the heart, and sees beyond what we wear. Most people are aware of that. In fact, He sees us as something even better than that. But we still try to impress each other with religiosity, with religious aesthetics. Sometimes that will be what is so-called traditional, and we go back to the skirts and ties and business casual sort of look. And other times it's like, okay, so now we have to appear out there like rock stars, and that's another aesthetic, more of a Jesus hippie, Jesus rock star thing aesthetic. But those are both, in a way, it's kind of like putting lipstick on a pig. We're making ourselves out to be more than we are, and that's branding. And I understand branding's important. You know, I get that. You know, I think about, who is this video reaching? Who is, how am I presenting myself in a way that communication can occur in its best way? Should I be wearing a t-shirt with the Japanese word for Batman on it? The answer is yes. But ultimately, all of this does not and should not matter, because when it comes down to it, we are simple vessels carrying the good news of Christ. This is why we are called jars of clay. Jars of clay were the simple tools used to transport water, to transport liquids. In Paul's time, these jars of clay were the most common thing. They were the generic Tupperware of his age. That's what we are. We are carrying treasure in generic Tupperware. In plastic dollar store, in America we have the dollar stores. There are similar stores other places in the world. Hakuyen stores in Japan. 2 euro shops in Ireland. Here we have the Chinese stores that that sell a lot of affordable things, and they all have, I think, the like plastic sealable containers. Generic plastic sealable containers. We wouldn't think about keeping our jewelry in these containers, but essentially, this is what what God is doing when he puts his glory into us, when he reveals himself through us. We ourselves are a simple vessel, but him shining through us, something very, very special happens. So let's take a look at what it is to be the jars of clay that God puts his treasured presence as something to be displayed from. As he reveals himself through us. Let's take a look at chapter 4 of 2 Corinthians, starting at verse 1, going through the end to verse 18. All right, chapter 4. Therefore, since through God's mercy we have this ministry, we do not lose heart. Now, when you have a ministry going, this is something that can keep pushing us forward. There is an energy that exists from being a Christian who is in an active ministry. Making these videos helps me get through the day. Knowing that I can come to you with the Bible is something very, very special for me. So I'm very, very thankful that I can demonstrate my simplicity and God's glory through these simple videos. Rather than renounce secret and shameful ways, rather we have renounced secret and shameful ways. We do not use deception, nor do we distort the word of God. On the contrary, by setting forth the truth plainly, we condemn ourselves to every man's conscience in the sight of God. So showing how great God is in a way that is honest and sincere, we end up humbling ourselves. We end up saying, it's like, God is great. I am obviously a simple person like you and everybody else. There's a level there. There's an equality. This is why what helps us to see that things are very egalitarian. Things are very, very equal from person to person. This is beyond culture. This is beyond politics. This is beyond gender. This is beyond race. This is beyond nation. This is beyond whatever walls we put in front of each other. We are still simple human beings meeting God in this simple state, in these simple clay pots, in this generic Tupperware. As these simple clay pots, as this generic Tupperware. We're generic Tupperware. And even if our gospel is veiled, it is veiled to those who are perishing. So if people don't see the good news, a lot of times they don't want to see it. And it's tragic. It's like, you know, you're just another... This is just more religious stuff. I don't want to look at this. I don't have time for this. You may be finding good things in this. I'm going to be finding good things in money. I'm going to be finding good things in power. I'm going to be finding good things in things that are not the gospel. I'm going to find good things in for putting the gospel in the background, but putting a big expensive suit on myself and waving my finger, saying... God wants you to be rich. You might be rich. You might not be. God loves you either way. We just talked about equality, and that also goes for economics. The rich, the poor, God meets you equally. Some rich people might not like hearing that. It's like, well, I'm obviously more blessed. You know, God's giving me more to be responsible with. It's like, well, I'm glad if you have that foresight, you know, I pray you're using it responsibly, but not in a way that you're holding yourself above the poor. Because if you're seeing things outside the realm of equality, you're losing the track that you're just a clay pot that God can be using to show his glory through. It doesn't help us to try to make ourselves to be the more special clay pot, the more special generic Tupperware. That doesn't help us. It's a status that we're all in. Now, there are other metaphors for us. We are invited into a royal priesthood. We are children of God. It's like we are special. God has given us titles that make us wonderful and special. And I would put being a clay pot, generic Tupperware, generic plastic tubs, containers, right alongside with our status of being a royal priesthood. They're not separate. They go together. But let us continue. Starting, going back to verse 3. And even if our gospel is veiled, it is veiled to those who are perishing. The God of this age has blinded the minds of the unbeliever so they cannot see the light of the gospel of the glory of Christ, who is the image of God. For we do not preach ourselves, but Jesus Christ as Lord. Ourselves as your servant for Jesus' sake. For God, who said, "Let light shine out of darkness," made his light shine in our hearts to give light of the knowledge of the glory of God in the face of Christ. So, again, we see God is investing in us. He's investing in Christians in a way to say, hey, I'm shining through these people. Now, I think that this can raise a whole lot of questions, especially in regards to this, what is shining? Is what is shining Jesus, or is what is shining, hey, this Christian has a big house, or a fancy car, or he has it all together, you know? We have to ask the question, is Christ standing out in our lives more than my success, more than my failure, more than all the things that we are experiencing? Is Christ the one that's coming through? It's a process that we go through as Christians, as coming back to a strong sense of self-examination in regards to where is Jesus in my life. Verse 7. But we have this treasure in jars of clay to show that this all-surpassing power is from God and not from us. We are hard-pressed on every side, but not crushed, perplexed, but not despaired, persecuted, but not abandoned, struck down, but not destroyed. We always carry in our body the death of Jesus, so that the life of Jesus may also be revealed in our body. For we who are alive are always being given over to death for Jesus' sake, so that his life may be revealed in our mortal body. So then, death is at work in us, but life is at work in you. So, simply put, despite the hard times that these jars of clay would go to, because you don't necessarily treat them the same way you would expensive plates. The nice, fancy plates that you may have or lying around. They don't receive the rough treatment that a simple clay pot would. Again, like generic Tupperware, generic plastic containers. But what's in these generic plastic containers, what's in us, that is God's investment. And it's an amazing thing. It's one of the reasons why Rory can keep coming back to God. Because while we're being presented as nothing special, God still shines through it. And it's a beautiful thing. I shouldn't say nothing special. No, that's not right. Because God cared enough to invest in us in the first place. It's more that the fact that God's special is what shines through us. Being jars of clay should not be derogatory, but an unpretentious description of the state that we're in. We should be as thankful to be jars of clay, generic Tupperware, as much as we should be children of God, saved, invited into a royal priesthood, continually renewed. We should be thankful for all of these things, and in that renewal, understanding our position as the jars of clay, as the generic plastic containers that are carrying such a great treasure. Verse 13, it is written, I believe, therefore I have spoken. With the same spirit of faith, we also believe and therefore speak. Because we know that the one who raised the Lord Jesus from the dead will also raise us with Jesus and his and present us with you in his presence. All this for your benefit, so that the grace that is reaching more and more people may cause thanksgiving to overflow to the glory of God. So again, we see that this grace is overflowing with God's glory and not the glory of man. And this is another important question that I think that we have to keep coming across. Is the glory going to God, or is it coming back to man? Is having a sermon where... And this is in my mind, is having a sermon where one man is speaking for a long period of time behind a pedestal, which is tradition. It is modern day tradition. Has been tradition for hundreds of years. Is that bringing glory to God, or is it bringing glory to that one man, that one super Christian? Again, this is why I talk about this in other videos. I have this vision for a church where you have multiple speakers. And those speakers can be met with questions. This is what I see as something that can be progressively helpful to Christians all over the world. And it's part of what I intend to do as a church. So we'll see how that goes. I'm gonna make some phone calls about that today. Therefore, we do not lose heart. Though outwardly we are wasting away, inwardly we are being renewed day by day. For our light and momentary troubles are achieving for us an eternal glory that far outweighs them all. So the glory that God gives us outweighs everything. It's an amazing gift, being kept inside us, shining through us, and goes beyond us despite our simplicity. So we fix our eyes on what is not on what is seen, but what is unseen. For what is seen is temporary, but what is unseen is eternal. Now, that sort of focus is what should exist in Christians in general, and leaders should be encouraging. Often we hear words of prosperity gospel saying, if you are successful, obviously God likes you. That's a dangerous teaching. It's more like kind of an economic karma than it is than it has anything to do with God's grace. It's dangerous. We don't see this displayed in Jesus or the apostles, who all at various times were living homelessly. God lived in a manner that was homeless. Paul talks about, in a way, not complaining, but also so people understand that he does need help. He explains that he lived homelessly. In my point of view, that's why he was a tent maker. I think that he learned how to make tents with his hands, and he traveled around so much that he could repair and make tents for other people as a trade. But yeah, they were focused. We see a focus there on the eternal, not what's temporary. To the extent where they willingly put their lives aside for the sake of the good news that Christ paid for our sins. This is an eternal truth. This is something that goes beyond worries about money. It goes beyond worries about our future, worries about our circumstances. And all of those are important. All of those are valuable. But Christians can find a peace in the eternal. Peace on what is unseen. That's what faith is. It's knowing what is, it's having a knowledge about what is unseen. And thankfully, it's a loving faith that we experience. I hope that you liked this video. Like, share, and subscribe. Feel free to comment. God bless you. And remember, even if you don't feel like you stand out too much, still, God shines through you as he needs to. He's active and doesn't stop working in and through you. Despite your humble circumstances, and sometimes because of your humble circumstances, God works through those things. So take care. God bless. L'arrivedere. And I'll see you next time in another video.